Hi, it's Vicky here, and welcome to the second day of my week featuring Averiel stamps. This is the North Pole Pulse stamp set. It comes with Santa and his wife, as well as those adorable reindeers. And there is also a matching die set available. I am going to combine that with another stamp set, which is called Chalet, and this is also the stamp set that I am giving away on my blog. So, as you can see, there are matching dies for this as well. I am going to use the houses from this stamp, and I am going for a little scene card today. So first of all, I am going to create a night sky. I'm working on a heavy cardstock by Simon Says stamp, and my go-to colors for my night sky are the three ones that you can see on screen right now. So I am going to blend in all those three colors on my panel, and I am starting with the purple. Now I am moving to the dark blue, and then once I am happy with all that coloring, I will add just a touch of black. Now, as I am blending, just to let you know that I don't press the blending tool too hard, I'm going very soft, and I go back again and again to load with a little bit of ink my blending tool. It's always better to add just a little bit every time than load it with too much ink and then you don't know how to move it. As always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. Also, don't forget to visit my blog post and enter your details for a chance to win one of these stamp sets that I am using today. So now that I'm happy with the coloring, I'm adding just a little bit of black to bring everything together. And now this is my night sky. You will see how this is going to transform once I add a little bit of gesso. So this is thick gesso, which I am going to water down with lots of water. I'm using a very thin brush, and I am going to add some splashes. So think of those splashes as stars, if you want to, or as snow. They work great for both ways. Now my night sky is ready. I'm going to leave that aside to dry, and I'm going to work on my focal points. So first of all, I'm going to stamp one of those reindeers, and I'm going with the guy in the middle who looks like he's flying, and I'm going to turn him into Rudolph. I'm stamping him with my Tuxedo Black ink, and that's because I will be working with my alcohol markers to color everything later on. From the other stamp set, the Chalet one, I am going to stamp the two houses available, but I'm not going to stamp them all, I just need the rooftops. And these are going to be cut out, and I'm going to stack them at the very bottom of my panel just to create a reference point. So this is going to give the illusion that the reindeer is far up in the sky. You will see what I mean later on. So today I'm using my Spectrum Noir alcohol markers. Somebody asked me yesterday if I have them, so I'm using them today. If you ask me, I think they are great. They blend really nicely, and they come in a very big range of colors. Of course, they are cheaper than Copic markers, so you can build up your collection easier. Now, I'm making sure that I have the caps on screen so you can see which colors I am using. And as you can see, I'm only using two colors to do the blending. I didn't even need to bring a third coloring marker. So once I'm happy with the coloring of the main body, I'm going to switch to darker colors, and you can see the caps right now, to color the rest of the parts from my little reindeer. I chose to color my reindeer quite dark, but you can go with lighter shades of brown if you wish so. I just wanted him to be quite dark in the dark sky. For his collar, I am planning to add some glitter there, so I don't really care about adding shadows. It's the same for the nose as well. You will see how I'm going to finish him at the end of the card. So now I decided to stamp the little bell that was included in the stamp set, which I am going to color it yellow as a base, and I will add some glitter at the end to that bell as well. Now to add a little bit of interest, with my white gel pen, I'm adding some dots at the top of his back. So my little reindeer is ready. I did color the rooftops as well, and now I am going to use the matching dies to secure them in place. I am using some repositional scotch tape, and then I am going to pass them through my die cutting machine, and I am placing everything at one pass, so I have them cut out all together. I am popping everything out, and it's time to assemble my card. To do so, I am going to stick down the rooftops first at the bottom of the panel. I am starting with one of the houses, which I am going to stick it directly on top. No dimension there. And I am going to use my scissors to cut out the excess. And now I'm going to decide where the other house is going to go, but this time I'm using foam tape at the back to add my dimension. I always need dimension on my cards, you know that if you follow me. So now I'm going to decide where this is going to go. Once I'm happy with it, I'm going to press it down and use my scissors to cut off the excess. Now, I always find it easier when I try to cut off the excess to turn my panel upside down and use large scissors. So this is where the reindeer is going to go, but first I am going to stamp the sentiment. Now, there are plenty of sentiments in both sets that I am using today, and I am trying to decide which is going to go where, but just because I have so many focal points, I decided to go with a small Merry Christmas from the Chalet set. I am going to stick it down on my acrylic block, and I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink. So I'm going to do a little bit of embossing. You know, I love embossing. It's my go-to technique for most of my cards. Now I am going to apply my embossing tool. Again, this is a tool that applies a little bit of powder to remove static electricity from my card, which means that when I am going to apply my white embossing powder, it's going to stick only where Versamark ink is. I have applied white embossing powder, and now I'm using my heat gun to melt the powder and heat set it. So my sentiment is ready now. I'm going to stick the reindeer, and of course I'm going to use some foam squares at the back. I am also going to add the bell. I have used tiny little foam square at the back as well. And this is my gold Wink of Stella glitter pen, which is going to add some gold glitter on the collar and the bell. For the nose, I'm using red stickles. This came in a pack of three, and they have perfect colors for Christmas cards. I'm going to link you that pack down below. So the nose is nice and shiny now, and my Rudolph is ready. As a finishing touch, I am going to add black enamel dots on his eyes, and these are going to bring the reindeer to life. Always remember to test out the bottle before you go ahead and make the dot directly on your project. So now that my panel is ready, I'm going to use a standard card. That's a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to stick my panel directly on top. Notice how the panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, which gives me a nice border all around. I always like to have borders on my cards because I think they give that finished look. Now I want to create a golden trail for my reindeer. As he's flying, he is leaving that gold dust behind. So I am going to use some sequins, and I have this mix of gold sequins which have inside some tiny little stars and tiny little dots. So these are the only ones that I am going to stick down. I'm not going for the bigger sequins. I am using my handy tool. This is the Pick Me Up tool, and I'm going to link you down below. I always get questions about that. And that was the card for today. I really love it. It makes me happy. So I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And don't forget to visit me tomorrow for another video featuring Averiel. Here is the first video of my week featuring Averiel, in case you haven't seen it. Thank you all for watching.